The House Education Committee has formally introduced a bill to increase teacher salaries. Now schools get their chance to react.
The primary goal is new guidelines for how schools should allocate their state funding. News 18's Marvin Bills spoke to a local school superintendent who says there are some potential problems.
I think spending works both ways. And so if you want schools to spend differently, I also think that the state of Indiana can spend differently on public education.
The House of Education Committee passed a bill that would raise teachers' salaries, but this raises questions on where the money will come from.
In this country, we spend $1.7 billion a year on standardized testing.
That's $1.7 billion that Superintendent Killion says can be placed effectively.
I believe that if we're going to test students, it should be measuring student learning over time, and it should be used for diagnostic purposes. It shouldn't be using to evaluate teachers and to evaluate school corporations on their effectiveness.
With a bill that requires more money to be used in the classroom and no help from the government, local communities face a bigger problem.
We're the number one nation in the world losing teachers by year five of their profession. And all the research shows that in order for a teacher to reach their optimum level of performance, they need to be in their 8th to 10th year, because practice breeds success.
While time waits for no man, this bill still remains in the beginning process. Community members still have the chance to turn things around for the future.
Local communities need to get involved. I think parents need to get involved. I think constituents need to be involved with this discussion. I also believe that more school districts need to engage their local representatives.
The decision still stands, but Superintendent Killion says the change starts here.
Well, the bottom line is that we all need to come together and do what's best for our students and for our teachers and for our respective communities.
Reporting Marvin Bills, News 18.
Killion says to follow the state guidelines, schools would have to cut funding in areas like special education and in maintenance.